Hey guys, and I'm not sure when this is gonna come out. It could be like tomorrow, which is Saturday? No, it's not Sunday. No, it's Saturday. It's Saturday. It could be Saturday or Sunday. I don't know. The reason why is because it's already like 7 p.m. and it's gonna take me not even that long to edit. It's just gonna take me a while to render and upload. So make it to you on Saturday, which is probably what's gonna happen. But on a side note, I just pre-ordered Overwatch, I don't really feel the need to pre-order Battleborn, considering I'm getting it on Steam, and I'm just gonna download it, so it's not like I'm gonna run out of a copy, or yeah, and what you get for pre-ordering it is kinda neat. It's like this gold skin, but I don't really care that much about that. But I am thrilled, like, extraordinarily thrilled that you guys are enjoying the Overwatch, gameplay. It was a really dicey thing because, again, a lot of the viewership on my channel is not... I've heard mixed things. I personally think it's really fun to watch. If you've played the game and you know what Battleborn is, then you will enjoy watching because you're going to know a lot of the things that are there. But as a person that's going to create videos out, I think the one thing that I'm going to have to do is constantly explain what's happening, because that's the other side of the spectrum that I've heard in other people's comments of the video, is the fact that it's a game that's kind of hard to follow. Not hard to watch, but hard to follow. So, for you to explain what you're doing is very important, and that's the one thing I didn't really do in my Overwatch gameplays. I kind of just did what I was going to do. I never told you guys I was trying to jump in for a kill. I never told you guys that I was trying to push the enemy back. I did, say that I was trying to get minions to spawn. I did all that kind of stuff. And yeah, there's gonna be a couple videos coming out. Again, there's a couple more characters that we're gonna cover. Boulder is one of them. Malik is one of the characters that you guys are gonna be seeing constantly, because that's the character that I played a lot. I played Shane and Oryx off camera a lot when the beta was just there, or just coming out, just to wrap my head around the game. And then Melka was the character that was an endgame character, and I kind of wanted to mess around with her a lot more. And when I'm watching the gameplay of what I'm doing, there's so many things where I feel like I could fix it or tweak it, so it's kind of good in that manner. It helps you improve with what you're going to do when you play that, the actual game. But yeah, just seeing, like, one, there, a lot of the videos got a substantial burst in views, not all of them, but some of them. Which was neat, so it brought in maybe some new people, but also, a lot of guys just generally got, like, into it. A lot of you guys liked what I was saying a lot of time, because a lot of the time in that game, there's some strong opinions. For instance, the fact that, an AFK player is, like, the worst goddamn thing on the planet, and it just makes your heart hurt, because it's just that bad. And yeah, that's the only thing I feel like I really should improve upon, is explaining what I'm doing before I'm going to do it, so... me do that next time. But yeah, also you guys are gonna be seeing a video I think on Tuesday, because I have quite a bit of videos scheduled to come out, so you guys are gonna be getting Battleborn for a while. It comes out May 3rd, so not next week, but next week. So yeah, not next week, the week after that. Boom, cool. Yeah, so some of the videos that you guys are gonna be seeing is, there's the last video I think that you guys are gonna see until the actual game comes out, which should be fine. Like, again, you're only gonna have to wait a little while by the time I actually run out of videos. But it's going to be a video talking about the lore of the characters, because I feel like that is going to be the one thing that sets off a spark for a lot of players out there, or potential players, because the biggest draw to this game, for me at least, is the characters. When I seen Shane Oryx for the first time, I was just like, I don't know what this game is or how to really play it, but that character looks beyond awesome, and I just want to see what happens. And I've seen some gameplay of people playing her, and she just looked like a blast to play. So I played her and, of course, loved it, and I feel like she is one of the most, if not the very most, loved character in all games. I haven't went into one game without seeing somebody pick her, which is insane. And that's not to say that she is an easy character to play, either. She has a pretty good learning curve. Like, you'll see people who get 3 or 4 kills when they play her, but then you'll see some people get 24. And it's just like, yeah, no, that guy perfected that character. Now, sadly, that's also something that I didn't really do. I wanted to bring you guys a lot of videos on this, and I wanted to keep you guys satiated for when the game actually comes out. So I never really dedicated any more than 2 hours to a character, which is... each game is like 30 minutes, so I only really played 4 games per character, which helps you get an understanding of that character, but not the exact way you play, or in the exact way you push, and the exact way you move. These are all things that are important that I never got the hang of, and I see some gameplays of people playing some of these characters, and I'm like, holy shit, like, they know exactly what that character can do, what its buffs are, what's its passives, everything to make that character strong. And then there's just me, just hitting a button a lot, trying to get some kills, which is fine, and it shows you the character, and I made sure to understand their skills, But just as of like this shit going on in the backworks, like the framework or whatever. Like for instance, Boulder, I never knew that Rage gave you a damage resistance. I knew it buffed your melee speed, but I didn't know it gave you a damage resistance, which is why I kind of messed up doing the Boulder video, because I spec'd for, I don't know what it was. I think it might have been the ability to get more damage when you throw your axe, instead of getting, whenever you do a shoulder bash or a shield bash, you activate Rage, which would give you 30 extra resistance and also melee speed, so it's just great. But yeah, Boulder is a ton of fun to play. I can't wait for you guys to see that video. Also there's just a random video where it's just gameplay oriented. It's just like, I think I have one with Cletus or Cleese, that's what it is. It's Cleese, not Cletus, it's Cleese. And Melka. I had two games where I didn't do any commentary, I just played them, and I thought, oh, that was a fun game. I think it'd be fun to watch, so then I'm just gonna make it in like one video. Even though we've already had a Melka and Cletus video, there's another one right after that, I think. Anyways, yeah, so there's also a lore video, because again, like I said, I think that's the perfect way to get you guys kind of sparked on the game, because again, the biggest draw to the game is characters, the immensely unique characters, and their lore behind them is super creative. If there's one thing the Gearbox is really, really good at, is making characters that are lovable, understandable, and goofy. And that's like my three favorite things that a character has to have. Which is funny, because I see a lot of the games that often fail, they try to make a character that is not understandable, but not likable. And that's like, you either have a character that is so goddamn interesting, like maybe you can't relate to him on any level, but you're interested in that character and the way he is. Maybe he's like a heroic type who acts selflessly, and you're like, I wouldn't do that shit, fuck that. But he does, and that intrigues you. Or there's a character that is the opposite. They're goofy, they make jokes, they have a certain outlook on life that you agree with, you know, that kind of thing, where they are understanding there. You can kind of sympathize with that character on some level, which is why I feel like games that do that make these characters that you do attach a little bit of yourself to do so well. And then I see some other games that don't do that. The games that, again, try to make that badass Duke Nukem-esque character that is not relatable in any fucking way, nor is he likable on any fucking way, unless you love the dudes like, hey, give me my beer, bitch, like, unless you like that guy, which that guy sounds like a total twat to me, but anyways, yeah, shit like that just weirds me out. Same thing with, The Order 1886 or whatever. A lot of people love the game, but that character to me, he was numb, he was docile most of the time, like, he didn't ever get to the point where he was like, hey, or, hey, like, you know, he was always either just mad and neutral. Like, I didn't ever feel like he maybe screamed a couple times in anger while just gunning down people, but as of like a character, didn't like him at all. Didn't really feel anything towards him, which is bad. Even as a creator and as a person that creates things, you want a reaction. Doesn't matter if it's good or bad, you want something. It's better to have a reaction than nothing. It's the worst thing ever if you get that from a creator standpoint. But anyways, yeah. 8 minutes of Battleborn, cool. It's pretty good, actually. Also, Overwatch beta is coming out May 3rd, too, so I'm not sure if that is Blizzard's cheeky way of being like, hey, we exist, too, and we're pretty fucking great. Because Overwatch, I've been amped for forever. I've been watching every single gameplay video of all the characters. Y'all want to know something pretty shitty? It's like a shit thing. I was looking at it because I don't like playing with keyboard and mouse. It just feels awkward to me, and I could dedicate some time to getting it, but I don't want to. I like just sitting back enjoying with a controller. My aim may not be perfect, but I don't want to sacrifice that for comfort. I play games to sit back and enjoy them, not to be like, oh, fuck. I'm not that. So, I looked up on Google to see if in the Blizzard Overwatch forums if there would be controller support for PC. And there was just this thread of this innocent guy just being like, hey guys, I don't really like playing with keyboard too much. I think I'm going to get the game on PS4 anyway. But do you guys know if in the open beta there's going to be a controller support? And then all these assholes just kept coming being like, hey, why would you want to like use the controller? You should just like use the mouse and keyboard. You're gonna get like no scoped across the map. This guy fucking knows that. Anybody who plays PC and who plays controller knows that it's far superior to play with mouse because you can react faster. We already know that shit. We don't need you telling me. I hate that so much when people are like, well, you didn't fucking know. I'm like, I did know. I spat so much. You see the spit mouth? Gross. Yeah, everyone always goes on about stuff like that. And I hate when people act like you do not know what you're talking about, but they do. And they then start to like correct you on shit that you explicitly said in your statement. Like, shit that they would imply that you know that said thing. They're like, well, actually, dude, this is how it works. And I'm like, Yeah, that's why I said that. At the point, like, I'm not lacked of information. My statement is correct because of that information. I'm not sure if I'm making sense. Let's back up a little bit. But yeah, essentially it was just weird. And then a dude was just like, well, then he shouldn't play the fucking game because he's being a detriment to his team that he's not using controller or he's not using keyboard and mouse. He's being a detriment to his team. He shouldn't fucking play. And I'm like, I want you to die. I actually want you to just get, like, I want to take off every label in your house that, like, just shows things are toxic and flammable and see how long you last, because your doucheness is going to kill you. The world's going to flip back. Okay, I'm mad. I'm sorry. Don't wish him any ill will. I just think he's an asshole. He'll never see this video, and if he does, hey, fuck you, buddy. Anyways, let's move on. But yeah, Overwatch, super hyped for that. I'm going to be playing with controllers, so it may not be the best. But whatever, I still like that I can, like, relaxing aspect of a controller instead of being on with my mouse and keyboard. Plus, the way my desk works, it won't be comfortable. Like, I'll have to do this, which I'm right in you guys' face, and I don't think you guys want that, nor do I. So I like sitting back here playing instead of being like, what's up? Like, hey guys, you guys can see every misperfection in my face. Let's do it. No, I don't want that. Oh shit, right. The whole streaming thing. It's not gonna happen this week. I think I did say it would happen this week, or I'd test it this week. But it will happen. Again, I still stand by that statement of me wanting to jump into that domain just to see if I do like it or not. Because I don't. I don't know if I do or do not like it. So I will stream for like a whole week at some point. But the fact that Overwatch is right over the corner, same with Battleborn. And I have two videos I have to make, which is what we're gonna talk about right now. And that's the fact that I need to make the Far Cry review. Now, before, when I say that, know that I'm not like, my review is superior, and I know you guys want to hear my opinion. I don't think that at all. But I did say immensely in that Let's Play that I would talk about and make a review and talk about the game and all of the stuff, which is going to involve me going back and listening to a bunch of people's opinions on the game when it just came out. And the main thing that people said was generic. And I want to headbutt people who say that, because it just doesn't make any fucking sense. The fact that a game without guns cannot be generic. It's like the... the fact that they're like, yeah, but it has the HUD of Far Cry, it has the, yeah, it's a fucking sequel. Like, what do you want? If it was a new title and it had all that shit, then yeah, there'd be some cause for concern, but there isn't. It's a sequel to a game, so it's going to share aspects of those sequels, because it wouldn't be a true sequel if it didn't. Fucking people are crazy. And they have their own opinions, and I respect them. I don't ever try to make my opinion sound dominant over yours. If you have an opinion, cool. I hope you respect mine as well. Oftentimes, that's not how it happens. A person commented on a video I made a while back when I was covering Destiny pretty heavily on my channel. I made a lot of, like, newsworthy videos where they're like, hey guys, this is what the community's talking about, and doo-de-bop-bop, that's pretty much it. But one of the things that I said, and it was a very unliked opinion, and you guys may hate this because you guys may be new, and you never heard this before, but basically in Destiny, there was this guy, right as the Taken King was coming out, and he said that, gamers will practically be throwing money at the screens for these emotes, basically just maker transactions. He said that gamers are going to be throwing money at the screens and they're going to be loving it and all that other stuff. And everyone got mad, as they justly should, because that was a very blunt way of saying what was actually happening. People hated that. People hated the fact that I wasn't just destroying this guy. The reason why I wasn't destroying him is because in games like CSGO, in games like, Dota, League of Legends, all of these games, I'm not sure if, I know one of them definitely has this, but anyways, all of these games are the ones that are pushing this idea, which if you are a game developer, you are intertwined with business, and ergo you are intertwined with making your game money. All of these games were just making bank on the fact that they were giving gamers pointless things that didn't offer them any advantage besides cosmetic things. And what were gamers doing? Throwing money at the screen. So he was just saying what was exactly happening in the gaming community at that said time, was gamers, and albeit I'm the same way, if there was something like a cool little trinket or like anything that gave me kind of like a neat little look that I personally loved, of course I would buy it. It is in my right to do so. But I also know that that would give me no advantage. Ergo, I just spent money on something that was completely looks-based, which is cosmetic-based. Everyone was like shitting on the dude, and I was kind of like, I think he's just saying what was happening in the industry right now, and no, do I think this guy should be in the limelight? Of course not. You can have a very horrible opinion, but you can have a better way of presenting that. And not a lot of people know that. Like, I feel like a lot of people are like scared of their opinion, but no, there's a perfect way to say a very clashing opinion. And yeah, of course the dude in the comment was like, hey, fuck you. And I'm like, okay, dude, settle down. I never said my opinion was superior. I just said that this was another perspective on that really shitty situation for that guy. Again, I don't know the dude. He could be a son of a bitch in real life. I didn't see him that way. But yeah, I feel like that was just a big thing that he messed up on, is he said the exact thing that was happening in the industry at the time, which was the fact that all these games were selling these tiny little microtransactions that every single gamer was eating up. And the companies were making bank from it. And he said it in the bluntest form, which was very bad, which was very, gamers got pissed real easy. So yeah, those are those kinds of weird things. But yeah, gotta make that a review for Far Cry Primal. I kind of want to make the review for Dying Light, albeit my ending thoughts on that game were kind of where I was at. Like, I kind of just thought the game was not rushed. I thought the game implemented mechanics and put too much weight on those mechanics. So for the driving mechanic, for you to not have any other means to get your destination, and for most places, you end up going down the same route to get to those said locations, was bad. The fact that there were story missions didn't really reward you, I say that, but in the game, I said the game constantly rewards you. It does, but not with things that you kind of want. Like the mission where you would get a handgun or a six gun that would do massive damage, that was amazing. Like, if they could have made that in every single story mission, I would have been overwhelmed and overjoyed, because they are constantly rewarding you for doing something, which is awesome, because I don't know, it's always a nice thing to do that, especially in a game that is very free-flowed, and it's not like a survival game. If it's a survival game, it's there to kick your ass, and it's there to be a nuisance to you. But in a game where like that, where it's pretty much just like, ah, just go have a good time, go have a fun time, they had mechanics in there that didn't really feel like that was the case. It felt like you were penalized for dying. You got spawned to an outhouse a mile away from your car, and you were like, fuck, god damn it. And I feel it's terrible for the people that didn't have the grapple hook, that had to literally walk that or run that. That sounded terrible. Anyways, so those are things that I might say in the review. But that's what I'll be working on this weekend, because I have kind of like quite a bit of Battleborn videos that I just edited like crazy, and had those up for you guys. Let me know about the music. I put some music in the background there. I wasn't sure if it was too loud or not. Not that I'm going to not put music in there, but just that, yeah. If it's too loud, I want to know about it. But, yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. Just a little check-in with me. A little talk about some stuff. Talk to them about some Battleborn. We talked about the fact that streaming is going to happen eventually. I just am booked like crazy. Booked? I sound like a tool. I have a lot of stuff going on right now. I have a lot of videos that I want to make and edit. Oh, shit. I don't have any Far Cry that I can edit with. It's pretty shitty. Okay. I really should have thought about that. They did upload a survival mode. I don't think it's that interesting, nor would I think it'd be fun to watch. It's pretty much just like a slow thing. Oh, by the way, yeah, I'm also going to be trying to make I'm not sure what I want to do with the video yet. I'm not sure if I'm going to jump in. Sorry. There is a Fallout 4 the update. It's like a workshop where you can like get death claws and put them in an arena and they battle, which sounds amazing. But I'm not sure if I'm going to make like a Let's Play-ish video, or if I'm just going to make a quick video where it's more like doing commentary dubbed, basically, like over the gameplay, and being like, hey guys, this happened, that happened, this happened, this happened, here's them fighting, boom, instead of me being like, alright, we're putting it together. Hey, I could just do that. I could do a Let's Play and a video like that, where it's like us creating the death trap arena, and then make the video where they actually fight, its own kind of dubbed talking over the gameplay kind of thing. I don't know. Regardless, guys, my name is Logan. Thank you guys so much for watching, as always. If you guys did like the video, you know what? You're fucking best. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Expect a lot of Battleborn. Hopefully you guys are enjoying those videos, because I'm going to make a lot more. So, again, that was why I intro'd the video being like, you guys like it, thank God. Because I love those games, and yeah, Overwatch and Battleborn, I feel like, are going to be the games that just take me like crazy. I can't put them down, so I'm glad to see that you guys are open to that kind of game, and yeah, I will get better at commentating on them and all that other stuff, as I always try to, and yeah, bye guys.